What's up, fellow travelers? My name is Brand, and over the last decade, I stayed at my fair share of hostels. Just in the last two decades, I stayed in over 20 hostels. With that, I've learned what to bring and not to bring during my stay. That is why, in this week's episode, I'm going to present 12 essential items you must consider bringing during your next stay in a hostel. That being said, let's just jump right into it, shall we? Compared to hotels, hostels don't always offer some of the take-it-for-granted amenities and tranquility you may be used to. That being said, here's my list of top 12 essentials you should consider bringing during your next travels. The first, and probably the most important item you should consider bringing when staying in a hostel are earplugs with an S. An S because you're gonna need tons of them. Unfortunately, when you stay in a hostel, you can get all kinds of sleepers and travelers. While some snore and some talk in their sleep, others arrive late at night and sometimes drunk and make tons of noise, which can ruin a good night's sleep. I remember once I was staying in an 8-person dorm room where 6 people were snoring all the same time. It was like an orchestra and not the one you want to pay for. If you're an active traveler just like me, you need a good night's sleep. That's why with a good pair of earplugs, you should be able to get through the night and enjoy your activities during the next day. In the same vein as the first item, you should always consider bringing a face mask when staying in a hostel. In hostels, travelers arrive at different times in the day, and some will arrive at 3 o'clock in the morning, and unfortunately and unsensibly will turn on the lights and wake everybody up and ruin a perfectly good night's sleep. Also, some dorm rooms don't have appropriate shades for their windows, which can block unnecessary light in the morning. That's why a really good and cheap face mask can come in handy in those situations. Another essential when staying in a hostel are quick drying microfiber travel towels, just like this one right here. While you should always consider bringing a towel when staying in a hostel because most of them don't provide one, you should consider bringing a microfiber towel. Compared to a regular towel, microfiber towels are usually a lot smaller, they can pack a lot easier, they dry way faster, and also they don't retain the smell of wetness as long. We all know that one of the worst things is when you have to pack a wet towel in your backpack on moving day. Well, compared to a regular towel, these towels dry within just a few hours. On the same note as the quick drying towels, you should consider bringing a face cloth that has a hanger on it during your next travels in a hostel. Just like towels, most hostels will not provide a face cloth for your stay. A face cloth with a hanger has about 2 main purposes. The first reason is after usage, you can hang up the face cloth on a coat rack in your dorm room and allows it to dry much faster and also avoid keeping some of the common smells associated with a wet face cloth. In some hostels, there's nowhere to hang your face cloth when taking a shower. You're mostly forced to hang your face cloth on a door or on a wall frame, which is pretty disgusting because sometimes those areas are not always properly clean. With a hanger, you can usually hang it up on something like, for example, the faucet. There's always a way to hang it up. The fifth item you must consider bringing when staying in a hostel are your daily essentials like shampoo, body wash, and etc. In fact, just like towels and face cloths, most hostels will not provide body wash or shampoo. And if they do, it usually is the same thing they give you to wash your hands when you're at the bathroom. And it even has the same smell, so probably better to avoid that. I highly recommend, especially for men, a 3-in-1 body wash, which contains a shampoo, a conditioner, and a body wash. This allows you to save space in your backpack, and also, it allows you to avoid bringing a bunch of containers with you when going to take your shower in the hostel. And by the way, guys, don't feel obliged to have to bring these things with you from your country of origin. If ever you forget, don't be stressed. Most of the products you're used to can be purchased in the city or country you're visiting. So don't worry. And on a side note, I recommend you bring a little Ziploc bag that you can put your containers in. That way there, your shampoo doesn't just burst in your backpack when you're traveling. God knows how many people I've met during my travels that's happened to them, and I thank every single day I bring that Ziploc bag just because of that reason. Another essential item that most people don't think of bringing, but I've been carrying with me for years now, is a disposable garbage bag. These bags allow you first to separate your clean from your dirty clothes within your backpack when traveling. Also, these bags can be useful when transporting your dirty clothes to a laundromat or to the hostel's laundry machines to do your laundry. In addition, in order to respect your fellow dorm roommates, these bags can be used to make sure that your dirty clothes are not on the ground and are properly stored away. I can't tell you how many times it's happened to me when I walk into a dorm room for the first time and I see some traveler's dirty clothes all over the floor just stinking it up. Considering that most hostels don't always have the cleanest showers, you should always consider bringing a pair of flip-flops or sandals or some form of footwear for your shower. While some showers are clean enough and flip-flops are not necessary, you should still always have them because you should try to avoid having direct contact with the shower floor with your feet. Furthermore, a good pair of flip-flops can be used to go from your hostel room all the way to the showers or the bathrooms and avoid putting on your shoes and all that. It allows us to not have to go bare feet in the disgusting, sometimes disgusting bathrooms. Another essential item you need to consider bringing with you when staying in a hostel is a really good power adapter. This may sound like a given, but power outlets are a rarity in hostel rooms sometimes. So I highly recommend you get a power adapter that has multiple outlets on it or has a bunch of USB plugins to allow you to charge your different electronics. For example, a few years ago, I purchased this power adapter for about $25 on Amazon. You don't have to purchase your things on Amazon. But this power adapter, number one, is very compact. It allows you to use in different countries very easily. And also, on the side, it has two USB ports with the power adapter. So this allows me to charge most of my electronics, most of my filming equipment when traveling. On a side note, sometimes when staying on a top bunk of a bunk bed, you don't always have direct access to a power outlet. In those circumstances, I highly recommend you bring with you an extended USB charger, which will allow you to charge your phone directly from your bed. The ninth item on my list is a really good safety lock. In most hostel dorm rooms, there is usually a locker or a bin under the bed that can be locked. But most hostels do not provide a safety lock. You either have to purchase it or buy one outside the hostel. When it comes to the type of lock, it's really up to you. In my opinion, I prefer a lock that has a combination to it. Why? Because that way I'm not afraid of losing my keys during I'm traveling, and I usually keep my home keys and all that locked up during the day so I'm not losing them or I'm not pickpocketed while I'm traveling. Also, you can keep the combination on your phone so not to avoid forgetting it. Trust me, it's happened to me in the past. That's my new trick now. Also, consider bringing two locks with you when traveling. That way there, in case one breaks or malfunctions, you still have a spare one. And don't bring a chunky lock. Most big locks will not fit in the lockers that are in hostels. I highly recommend you consider bringing a small little lock that will usually work and just keep people away from trying to break into your things. When staying in a hostel that has access to a kitchen, I highly recommend you bring a reusable water bottle and also a reusable Tupperware. A really good Tupperware is useful for two ways. Number one, allows you to store your foods in the kitchen fridge. Also, you can pre-make a lunch for the next day and save money on food when traveling. Having a really good, handy, reusable water bottle is good in so many ways. Number one, allows you to save money by not purchasing water. Number two, it's good for the environment because you're not purchasing non-reusable water bottles. And finally, it allows you to have access to water when you're in your room and when you're on the go during the day. The 11th item on this list is a really good small travel size first aid kit. While I'm sure most hostels have one, you should still be on the safe side and bring one with you during your travels. Also, consider bringing some essential non-prescriptive medication like Advil and Tylenol during your travels. Just a little disclaimer here, please consult a pharmacist before purchasing and using these to make sure you're using it for the right purposes and the right needs. Finally, guys, the 12th item in this list, and it's, by the way, one of the most important ones and also a free one, is to bring a smile and an open mind when staying in a hostel. You have to be open-minded in the sense that you have to be ready to just accept the hostel you have. Now, it doesn't mean you shouldn't make complaints if the hostel is dirty and doesn't meet proper standards. But still, hostels are not hotels. You are paying a cheaper price for a reason. So be open-minded when it comes to that. Secondly, people in hostels are from different countries with different values and different perspectives. So if you want to meet people and get to know them, try to avoid divisive subjects such as religion and politics. And like I always say, guys, people make the destination. So in hostels, be open-minded and don't be shy. Well, guys, that was my list of 12 essential items you should consider bringing next time you plan on staying in a hostel to make it a more enjoyable time. And guys, if you enjoyed this video and want to see more travel tips, tricks, or vlogs on a weekly basis, hit the subscribe button down below and leave a comment if you have any other items that you think are essential for traveling. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and don't forget, safe travels.